Human minds are truly remarkable, especially when it comes to our mystifying memory, which separates us from other species living on this planet. We all have a favorite recollection of a beautiful moment in our lives, and we also have memories we would like to forget completely. No matter what type of memory it is, it's all stored in the brain and retrieved when we need it. The question is, how does our brain store memories? Let's dig right into it. Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back. Hello and welcome to another exciting episode of Fancied Facts, where we tackle fun and interesting facts for your curious mind. Our brain's ability to collect, reconnect, and create a mixture of milliseconds-long fragments of impressions is the basis of every memory. Every sensory event triggers a change in the molecules of our neurons, reshaping the way they connect. This means that our brain is made of memories, and memories make up our brain. It also means that memory occurs because our brain's molecules, cells, and synapses can tell time. It all begins when the brain responds to an outside stimulus and compounds it to rewire the neurons. The brain stores memories in two ways. Short-term memories like remembering to lock the door when leaving your home or to buy bread when grocery shopping is processed in the prefrontal lobe, according to McGill University and the Canadian Institute of Neurosciences, Mental Health and Addiction. Short-term memories are decoded into long-term memories in the hippocampus, a deeper part of the brain. The hippocampus takes simultaneous memories from different sensory areas of the brain and connects them into a single episode. For instance, you may remember an enjoyable journey you had rather than multiple detached recollections of what the trip looked like, smelled, and sounded, and instead the experience is packaged as a beautiful holiday. When memory is processed through the hippocampus, the connections between neurons become a fixed combination. So when you hear a wild animal, you might be swamped with flashes associated with an episodic memory that takes you back to a wild adventure expedition. Furthermore, human memories, even our favorite ones, start at a minuscule scale. Your mother's voice when she spoke to you for the first time in your life began in your auditory cortex, which transforms the sound waves into electrochemical signals. Her face started as a scatter of photons on your retina, which sent a signal to your visual cortex. Afterward, hormones layer the experience with context. You know this person is lovely and 100% safe. These senses and many others are practically infinite number of inputs raining across our brain. And by the way, no memory exists by itself. Your brain breaks down experiences into various time windows experienced concurrently. For example, the sound is broken down into different frequencies perceived simultaneously. This is a nested system that contains individual memories existing within various time windows of fluctuating lengths. Every part of the memory consists of time windows, including molecular exchanges of information that are practically invisible at the scale when you recall the event. The whole process is too complicated to fully grasp, even for neuroscientists who are at the forefront of understanding how the brain stores memory. However, they're making progress on how all this works to unlock more of our brain's mysteries. If you enjoyed this episode, please leave us a like and subscribe for more enjoyable uploads in the future. As always, thanks for watching and enjoy your day!